This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, let's start. Hope it's audible to everyone. Okay, so last class we discussed about what views we have seen: database view, projection view, and what maintenance view. And we understood the difference between those three views. Okay, so just to quickly summarize, database view, first of all, views are used for what? Hiding the original tables, hiding the original data, hiding the fields. Okay, and we have four types of views. And one more thing is, views doesn't exist physically. The data in the view will be populated only in the runtime. And we have seen that there are four types of views: database view, projection view, maintenance view, and what? Help view. And the differences between them is, a database view can be created on one or more tables. Projection view can be created only on one table. Maintenance view also can be created on one or more tables. Okay, and in case of database view created on multiple tables, we need to manually provide the join conditions. In case of maintenance views, the tables that we need to provide only single table, and we have the option to select the dependent tables, and those dependent tables should have what? Foreign key relationship. Okay, then only we can go for what? Maintenance view. And the other differences, we cannot generate table maintenance for database view and projection view, whereas table maintenance is possible for maintenance view. And another difference is, in case of database view created on multiple tables, the maintenance status is always read-only. In case of maintenance view created on multiple tables, the maintenance status can be read-only or read and change, read, change, delete, and insert. Okay, right. So we'll see one more example on maintenance view. Right, we'll see one more example on maintenance view. So one agenda of maintenance view is what? We can what? Link all the dependent tables as what? Single object. We can link all the dependent tables and maintain them as what? A single object. Okay, so that is nothing but called as what? A view cluster. Okay, if you link multiple dependent tables together and maintain them as a single object, that concept we call it as what? View cluster. View cluster means it's a collection of what? Maintenance views. Okay, so we have some material tables. Okay, we have some material tables like what? Mara table. Okay, which stores the general material data, material description. MAKT table stores what? Material description. MARC table stores what? Material plant. Like this, we have many tables. MARD will store material storage data. So the relationship between these tables is what? One entry of each material of Mara can contain one or more descriptions in what? MAKT table. For example, see here. Let me open those tables. Yeah, so let me take Mara table, which contains what? Material master data. MAKT table, which stores the material description data. MARC table, which stores the material plant data. MARD table, which stores the material storage location data. Okay, so if you see the relationship, Mara table will store what? General material data. The primary key field is what? Client field and what? Material number. So in the Mara table, we'll have what? Many materials. You have around 18,000 materials are there. Let me check for one of the material number. So what is the key field in this table? MATNR, material number. So if you go to this table, I'm having a material 100-100. This is one of the material number. So we have an entry led to this. So when I execute this, so this table will contain what? Material master data. Okay, material number is a key field here, right? Now based on this material number in Mara table, let me check the descriptions in MAKT table. So if you go to MAKT table, it stores what? Material descriptions. What are the key fields here? Client field, material number, and language key is a what? Primary key fields. So if I go to this contents, here we'll have what? Many material descriptions. I am interested to check the descriptions related to which material? 100-100. So in MAKT table, I'll give the material number as 100-100. How many descriptions are there? 15 descriptions are there. So for this material, there are 15 material descriptions maintained. Okay, each description is specific to a language, Chinese, Japanese, all those, English, okay? Understood? These are all the language keys. Okay, done. Now, let me go to MARC table, which stores the material plant data. What is the key field here? Client field, material number, and plant. Material number and plant. These are the three primary key fields. So if I go to contents, let me, here also we are having what? Material number. So if I go to contents, let me check how many materials are there here. How many plants are there? For this material, a material might contain what? Zero or one or more plants. So if I go to number of entries, yes. This material has got how many plants? 17 plants. So when I execute, it will show you the 17 plants information. Done. Let me go to another table, MARD, which stores a storage location data for what? Material. Here the key fields are what? Client field, material number, plant, and what? Storage location. So in MARC table, let me take one combination. This is 100-100 is a material number and 1000 is a plant. So with this combination, let me check how many storage locations are there. So if I say 100-100, followed by what is the plant? 1000. For this combination, I want to check the storage locations. We have two storage locations. Okay, for this material plant, we have two storage locations. So what is the relationship between these tables? Each material of Mara table may contain n number of material descriptions, and each material might contain n number of plants, zero or one or more plants, and each material plant may contain zero or one or more storage location. So what I am trying to say is all these four tables data are what? Dependent data. Means they're all the data related to what? Materials only. So now what I can do here, if I generate the table maintenance for each table, I can maintain each table data separately. But what I want to view all this table data as a single object. Means in a single object, based on a material, I should able to check all the descriptions. I should able to check all the plants. I should able to check all the what? Storage locations. Or if I do any database operation, means I want to insert. I want to insert the material data, general data, descriptions, plant data, storage location. So all those database operations I want to perform in a single object. So what I have to do? I have to group these four table data. I have to group these four table data and maintain it as what? Single object. So this grouping of data, I can do it through what? View cluster. So the base for view cluster is what? Maintenance view. Why maintenance view only? Because in the last class you have seen, for a database view and projection view, we cannot generate what? Table maintenance. Table maintenance is possible only for maintenance view. So my agenda is what? I want to group all this dependent data into a single object so that user should able to maintain all this dependent data in a single object, something like this. Means I should get a report kind of view cluster T code is what? SE 54. So by running this T code, I should able to see the material master data. When I choose this material number, I should able to choose the view the plant data. If I choose material and plant, I should able to view the corresponding storage data description like this. What all the dependent data I want to maintain in a single object so that I can perform all the CRUD operations in a single object. So when I perform the CRUD of a single object, it should reflect all the base tables. So this is possible through what? View cluster. So view cluster means grouping all the views, grouping all the views into a single object. So what are the things I want to group? If you see this requirement, yeah, I want to group these three things. What are they? Okay, I'm not taking descriptions. I'm taking only material, general data, material plant data, material storage data, something like this. Okay, so for this, what you have to do is, first of all, you have to create maintenance view for each, based on each of these tables separately. Then we have to generate table maintenance for each of those views. Then we have to group all those three maintenance views into a single object, and that is done by using what? View cluster. Okay, so what I'll do now is, first I have to create what? I have to create a maintenance view on what? Mara table. Then I have to generate the table maintenance for that. Then I have to create the maintenance view for material plant data, generate the table maintenance, then create the maintenance view based on MARD, generate the table maintenance. Then by using this view cluster, I need to group all those three maintenance views so that I can maintain them as single object. And you can see there are some fields repeating in this between these tables. In Mara table, we have what? MANDT and what? MATNR. Here also we are having what? MANDT, MATNR, and what is the primary key field? Plant. So again, I should not show this is the same data, and again I should not show the same data in the second node here. Okay, I should show only the data from plant, because the data for material number and client field is shown by the top node. Then again, here also we have what? MANDT we have, MATNR we have, in this table also we have plant, and then we have what is the primary key field? LG what? These are the four primary key fields, but the data for these three fields are already shown by the parent node. So again, I should not repeat that. Means when I construct this object, I should not repeat the same data. I should not repeat the same fields data. Okay, I should show it only once. Okay, so this is what you have to take care while creating this particular view cluster. So first, what I have to do, I have to create the maintenance view on what? Mara table. Okay, so before that, let me quickly create the function group. I have deleted some of the function group, so let me create the function group, because we require it for what? Table maintenance. I'll go to SCAT. I'll create a new function group. I can use the existing one, but I may have the errors in that. So z645 underscore f group. This is my function group. I'll save it in the local object. Activate the function group before we use it. Right, function group is activated. Now, first let us create the maintenance view on what? Mara table. So I'll go to SC11. I'll give the view name. Let me give it as something Z645 Mara view, some name Z645 Mara view. Create what type of view? Maintenance view. Why we are going for this maintenance view? Only because we can generate table maintenance only for maintenance view. Done. Then let me give a description. Done. So what is the table here? Mara is the table. Done. I'll select the required fields. By default I'm getting the primary key fields. I'll choose table fields. Let me select some other fields: material type, industry sector, and material group. So I'm selecting some fields here. Done. Then this is nothing but called as projection. This is nothing but called as projection. Done. Next, I'll go for selection here. I don't want to expose the complete table data. I want to expose only those table data where the material type is equal to raw material ROH or material type is equal to what? Finished product. Okay, so this is my selection condition. Material type is equal to raw material or material type is equal to finished product. I'm selecting the required fields. Done. I'll choose the option as rechain, delete, and insert so that I can perform all the DML operations. Let me save it. Check for the syntax error. Activate your maintenance view. And for this maintenance view, we need to generate the table maintenance. I'll go to table maintenance generator, authorization group. I'll provide the function group Z645 underscore F group. Z645 underscore F group is the function group. I'll go for what? One step or two step? Anything is fine, right? So I'll go for what? Two step. Let me generate the screen numbers. Done. I'll create the table maintenance. Yeah, table maintenance is generated. Done. So if you go to SM30, we can see the table maintenance. If I click on the maintain button, as of now we can see only the material master data, because this maintenance view is created based on what? A base table called that Mara, which is nothing but material master data. So if I try to maintain, as of now I can see only material master data. I want to check whether I am able to see only raw materials and finished product. Yes, you can see material number, material type, industry, material group. So you can see the material types, only finished product and what? ROH. Only finished product and ROH are the material types. Done. Done. Okay, so this is only material master data. Done. So now let me create maintenance view based on other table. So I'll give the name as something MARC view. MARC view create. I'll choose what? Maintenance view. I'll give the description as maintenance view for material plant data. Done. I'll give the table name as MARC view fields. By default you'll get the primary key fields. Then let me select some other fields also. Okay, works is I took, then I'll take what purchase group. Like this, I can choose what some of the fields done. Okay, then selection conditions, if you want to give, you can give done. Now here one thing I'll do. What I'll do is here, if you have from this table, I took how many fields? Four fields. Out of these four fields, the data for this first two fields, the data for this first two fields will be filled by what parent node only, na? So what I'll do, since it is filled by parent node, okay, here we have a column called as P position. Yeah, here I'll choose something S here. S indicates what here, see, view field is used to form subsets. Means the meaning of this entry is the data for these two fields is filled by what parent node only. Okay, it will come as what subsets. Done. Let me save it. Selection condition I'm not giving. Yeah, option will be like this. I'll activate this. Done. So why I'm choosing this one is, even if you don't choose also no problem, but unnecessarily in the second row also that MANDT, MATNR will be shown to the user. I don't want to show, because the data for these two fields is already shown in the parent node, parent record. That's why I'm not, I don't want to show it. So I'll create them as what subsets. Done. After activating this, generate the table maintenance. I'll go for two step, propose the screen numbers, create the table maintenance. Right, so table maintenance is created. Done. Now let me go for MARD view. Choose maintenance view. Provide the table name MARD. By default, you'll get the primary key fields. If you want some additional fields, I'll take them. Let me take something PSTAT, maintenance status, it seems. Done. Overall, five fields I took. Selection conditions, nothing is there. Yeah, in the view fields again, if you see these first three fields, the data for this first three fields is already provided by the parent node. So this also, I'll give it as what subsets. This also, I'll give these three fields, I'll give it as what subsets, which indicates what the data for these fields will is shown by what parent node. Done. Let me save it. Activate your maintenance view. Generate the table maintenance for this. Yeah, authorization group, I am giving this only. Okay, going forward, I'll show you how to create our own authorization object and how to assign the users to that. Done. I'll choose two step. Done. Table maintenance is generated. Right, request completed without us. Let me generate the table maintenance for this. Oh, already generated, sorry. Table maintenance is not generated. Done. Okay, so we have what table maintenance for what each of them. So I'll go to SM30, maintain, done. You can see here, it is asking client material plan, because the data for these three fields is filled by what parent node only. So that's why I'll just give some data here. For this combination, it will show me the storage locations. Done, working fine. Okay, so I'm having three independent maintenance views. Okay, so if you want to maintain, I have to go to SM30. Here, if I give this one, it will show only material master data. It will show only material master data. Okay, and if I give MARC, it will show me the material plant data. Okay, material plant data. Okay, and if I go for MA, it will show the metal storage data. But I want to group them. I want to group all those three so that I can maintain them as a single object. Now we have to go for something called a view cluster. Cluster means a group, a collection. So I'll go to SC 54. I'll go to SC 54. Okay. So in SC 54, what you have to do is, after going to SC 54, generate table maintenance dialog. Generate table maintenance dialog. There is a button on the application toolbar, edit view cluster. Click on the button, edit view cluster. Done. Provide the view cluster name. Okay, cluster should have a name. I'll give the cluster name as something Z645 material cluster. Some name. Z645 MAT cluster. This is the name of my view cluster. Click on create or change. Done. I'm getting some information message. Continue. Let me save it in the local object. Done. Right. So you can see here we have a tree structure here. What is the first node here? Header entry. Just you have to give us some short text here. I'm just giving some short text. Done. Okay. So other fields are not required. So in the header entry, as of now, I'm just giving the short text. Okay. Then come to what object structure. So in this object, if I double click on the object structure, here I need to group all the maintenance views. In the object structure, I need to group all the maintenance views. So there is a button here, new entries, provide the name. What is the first maintenance view name? Z645 MAMARA view. Okay. Then what is the other one? Z645 MARC view. Then what is the other one? Z645 MARD view. Z645 MARD view. So when I press enter, right? When I press enter, done. Yeah. Okay, so I'm getting these buttons here. Keep on pressing enter. If you want to give any short text here, you can give. So I'll just give a short text as something. I'll give a short text as material, meaningful short text, material master data. This I'll give it as material, what? Plant data. This I'll give it as material, what? Storage data. Done. Okay, so if you see the requirement here, the first node should show me what material master data. So this is the first node and this is a parent node. Okay. Before this, I don't have any other node. Okay. Before this, I don't have any other data. So here it is asking predecessor. Okay. It doesn't have any predecessor. This is a startup one only. So give the same thing. Z645 MaraView. And for MARC, what is the next one here? Plant data. For this, who is the parent? This metal master data. Na? So here you give a predecessor as what? Z645 Mara view. Okay. And for MARD, for material storage data, the parent is what? Plant. Na? So here you give it predecessor is what? Z645 MARC view. Am I clear? For Mara, we don't have any parent. So give the predecessor as same thing. Okay. For MARC, the parent is what? Mara. For MARD, the parent is what? MARC. So provide like this. And dependencies. Yeah. DEP means dependencies. So if you browse this, R indicates what are header entry, means topmost node. I'll choose R. Then here, if you browse this, here we have S and M. I can choose any of them. Dependent entries can be maintained only for one IA level entry. So I'll choose what? S. Nothing but child here. Okay, subset kind of thing. Dependent entries can be made for an entry. Done. So R indicates what? Header entry, it seems. And S indicates like child kind of thing. Done. Position. So I can give some positions here. 1, 2, 3. And there is another column here, start. Which is the startup node here? The first one is so choose start. Okay. So I clicked on the, double clicked on the object structure. I clicked on the new entries button. I will get this table maintenance, provide all the maintenance views which you have created. And for each maintenance view, maintain the predecessors and which is header entry, which is subsets, and give the positions here. Done. Then after this, okay, let me save it, done. Then after this, what you have to do is, choose each entry. There is a button here in the same object structure only, choose each entry, and there is a button here, generate field dependencies. Choose each entry and click on generate field dependencies. So when I click on this generate field dependencies, so it will generate the dependencies between these three entries. Okay, so I'll choose this, click on generate field dependencies. What is the information I got? Field dependencies successfully generated. Then choose the second entry, field dependencies successfully generated. Choose the third entry, field dependencies successfully generated, done. So field dependencies are generated, done. Now you need to activate. So for activation, again, go back to what? Header entry, double click on the header entry. There is a button, what? Activate. Let me click on activate. Should the sub object maintenance screen be modified? Okay, let's say yes. Yeah, what is the message I got? View cluster so and so was saved and what? Activated, done. So it might have created. Let me maintain it. So I'll just go back. Yeah, here we have a button what? Test. I'll click on the button test. I'll click on the button test. Done. Good. You can see the hierarchy here. So I'm getting a report kind of thing, something like this. Okay, you can see this is the startup node, which is the startup one here, material master data. Done, it is showing that. Okay, now for this material, I want to check the plant data. So I'll choose this, click on what? Material plant data, double click on that. Done. What is the client number? 800, continue. Yeah, so for this material, might be we have only one plant. We have only one plant, okay? Now for this material and plant, I want to see the storage data. I'll double click on the storage data. Client is 800, continue. Yeah, one entry chosen. So for this material and plant, we have one storage location, okay? Now if I want to insert material master, click on what? New entries. Right, I'll give the material number as something 645 underscore material one. Material type, I'll give it as raw material. Okay, understood. I can browse and choose. I'm giving the material type as what? ROH. Industry sector, I'll give pharmaceuticals. Material group, I'll give something 001 kind of thing. I'm just press F4. I'll give 001 metal processing, done. Let me click on save. Yeah, metal is created. So in which table this metal is data is stored? This is the metal master data. It will go and sit in what? Mara table. Let me go and check. Okay, what is the material number I give? 645 underscore mat one. So when I execute, yeah, okay, this is the material created, material number, material type is raw material, industry sector is pharmaceuticals, metal group is what? 001. Done. Okay, other fields are not maintained, done. Now for this material, I want to maintain the plant data, so I'll click on what? Material plant data, done. Nothing is there. I'll click on what? New entries. Okay, so I'll give some plant here, 1000. I'll give some purchase group. I'll just use some purchase group. Let me save it. One data is saved. So this data will go and sit in which table? MARC table. So if I go to MARC table, what is the middle number? 645 underscore mat one. I maintain only one plant data. Yes, I got the plant data. If I go to MARD, material storage data, as of now, I have not maintained any storage data. So if I go to contents, if you see the material number, what it is saying, no table entries found. So as of now, I have not maintained any storage data. So for this material, I want to maintain the storage data. I'll double click on this. Okay, for this material and plant, I'll click on new entries. I'll give some storage location, something. Okay, done. Maintenance status, I'll just keep it blank. Let me save it. Yeah, data is saved. So the data will go and sit in what? MARD table. So if I go to MARD, number of entries is one now, right? So when I execute, it has stored the data in this. Understood? So what is the advantage here is all the dependent data, we are maintaining it as a single object. Okay, so I took what the MARA tables, I took the material tables. You take the sales documents tables, VBAK, VBAP. You take purchase document tables, EKKO, EKPO. You take your own tables, but the tables must have the foreign key relationship. The tables must have what? Foreign key relationship. Okay, like employee table and department table. Last 2 days back we have discussed. Okay, I should be able to maintain the employee data and dependent data as a single object. So like this, we can go for what? View cluster. Done. Any questions? Yeah, now we have one more view. What is that view? Help view. Okay, so one second. I'm just trying to create the help view. One second. Yeah, before this, yeah, we have some tables here. Z9AMEMP. This is a 9AMEMP table. I'm having another table. Z9AM department table. Okay, I think these two tables are what interlinked using what foreign key. Let me check. So in the employee table, I'll choose this entry. I'll click on what foreign keys. Yes, already foreign key relationship is maintained between these two tables. Okay, so already we know the concept of foreign key. When do we go for foreign key? When the data of one table is based on another table, we go for what foreign key. Done. So keep that in mind. Now, yeah. So we have the foreign relationship. What is the logically related field between these two tables? Department number is a what? Department number is a logic related. D number in a department table, DPT number in what? Employee table. So keep these two tables in mind. I'll go to employee. Okay, first of all, let me go to department table. Let me check any entries are there in this table. Good, we have four entries. What are the available department numbers? 10, 20, 30, 40. And if you come to the employee table, if I go to contents, number of entries are 14. Done. Yes, good. So here you can see we have 20, 10, 30, 20, 10, 30, 50 is there, 6 is there, 7 is there. So there are some. Okay, let me delete some of them just to avoid confusion. Okay, it's not maintained here. Done. I think I have done the table maintenance. Fine, no problem. So these are the records here. So you can see there are some department numbers here, 5676304. Okay, so these departments are not there in department table. Now what I'll do quickly is, based on these two tables, let me create the database view as well as what? Help view. Okay, so quickly understand. So I'll go to SC11. I'll try to create a database view first. I'll give the name as zdbview_emp_department. Okay, this is my database view. Already we know if you create the database view on multiple tables, we need to provide the join condition, and database view follows what? Inner join. So I'll just click on create. I'll choose what? Database view. Done. I'll give the name of this as short description. One second, please. I should not give underscores. Let me remove the underscore. ZDB view, EMP department, create that. What do you want to create? Database view. I'll give a short description. Database view and EMP and what department done. Table name. What is the first table? Z9AM EMP. What is the second table? Z9AM. Or let me give first like this. Z9AM department. What is the other table? Z9AM what? EMP. Done. Okay. So these are the two tables I give. Department and EMP. I need to provide the join condition. What is that? Z9AM department of. Z9AM department of. What is the field here? D number. Okay. D number. And then here I'll say Z9AM EMP. What is the field name here? Department number. Understood? The field names are what? Different. In the employee table, the field name is DPT number. The field name is DPT number. Done. So I gave the join condition between these two tables. Done. I'll go to view fields. Yeah, I'll go to view fields. One second. First, let me give EMP. Then here I'll give what department. I'll do in a reverse way. This I'll give Z9AM EMP. What is this? Department number. Z9AM department. What is this? D number. I'm giving in a reverse way. First employee department, then so on. So done. I'll go to view fields. First, let me select the fields from employee table. Let me select all the four fields from the employee table. Done. Let me also select all the three fields from department table. Done. Done. Okay. Now I'll go to selection condition. I'm not giving the maintenance status. Since database view is created multiple tables here, the status is always read only. Let me save it. Check for the syntax error. Done. So what is this view status here? Read only. Read only means maintenance is not possible. So this is the wrong option. So I'll choose what display maintenance allowed with restrictions. Allowed means what? I should be able to perform all the operations, but here it is what? Read only. So I have to choose allowed with restrictions. Let me save it. Check for the syntax. Done. Activate this. So the database view is what created. And I told that database view follows what inner join. Okay. So if I go to contents, number of entries is 7 only. I got what 7 only. So see here. Yeah, you can see actually this employee table. If you see, employee table has got how many entries? 14 entries. But I got only 7 entries. Why? 50 is not there in the department. 1, this is ignored. This is ignored. 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, these 7 records are what ignored. Inner join means what? Each row of the left hand side table will be compared with all the rows of right hand side table. Okay, so this is available. Pick that up to this is available. 50 is not there, so it will ignore this record. 6 and 7 is also not there, it will ignore this record again. 6304 different numbers is not there in department table. It is ignored overall the 7 records. So I got in the output, I got what in the output? I got what? 7 entries. This is inner join. Already we know the concept of inner join. Now what I'll do, let me create the help view. Help view will follow what? Left outer join. So already we know always left outer join may have what? More entries compared with what? Inner join. Because in case of left outer join, what happens? It will consider all the rows of what? Left hand set table. Even if there is no matching row in the right hand set table will be filled with what? Zeros and what? Space. So this is your database view. Now I'll create help view. So just try to understand. I'll go to SC11. I'll give the name as something ZHP view, something ZHP view, EMP and department. Create. I'll choose what? Help view. Done. I'll provide the description. Help view and EMP and what department. What is the table name? Z9AM EMP. I cannot give multiple tables here. I have to choose them through relationship, which will have what foreign key relationship. Yeah, it is showing me the table. Done. Automatically it is proposing the join condition. Automatically it is proposing the join condition depending on the foreign key tables are selected. Done. I'll go to what? View fields. Yeah, I'll go to view fields. Done. This is fine. Oh, sorry, I'll select all the fields from employee table. Done. I'll select all the fields from department table. Done. Okay, done. Selection condition and not get anything. Maintenance status, I can choose read only or read and change. I can go for read and change. Let me save it. Check for the syntax error. Oh, field maintenance status value use not permitted. Update is not permitted. But if the update is not permitted, they should not have given that. Okay, I'll choose read only. Let me save it. Check for the syntax. Yeah, actually they would have disabled that radio button, but they gave it as read and change, so it is not allowing me. Done. So I created the help view. Okay, I created the help view. Let me check whether I can generate the table maintenance here. I'll go to utilities. No, table maintenance is not possible for help view also. Table maintenance is possible only for what? Maintenance view. Done. So if you see the database view here, okay, database view is giving me how many records? It is giving me what? Some 7 records it's giving. If you see the help view, okay, I'm unable to see the contents here. Okay, I'm unable to see the contents here. So where I can use this help view means, help view, I can use it in what? Search help. I can use it in what? Search help. Okay, I cannot see the contents here. Okay, so now what I'll do is I'll go to what? Search help. So what is this search help means? It's very simple. Search help is nothing but it is used for providing what? F4L. Already we have seen how to provide F4L. How to provide F4L for what? Selection screen input field. Okay, in selection screen programming, already we have discussed how to provide F4L for what? Selection screen input field. How to provide, we need to handle an event called as what? At selection screen on value request. Okay, we have to handle this event. And inside this event, in order to populate the F4 values, we are calling one function model. F4 if int underscore table underscore value underscore what? Request. Right, this is the function model we are calling to populate the F4 value. So this F4 is what? Local to the program. Okay, within that program, that F4 functionality will be available. Now we are having search help in what? Database level. So when do we go for search help is, if the same F4 help, if you want to populate in multiple objects, you'll go for what? Search help. Understood? Whatever we discussed earlier, it will work absolutely fine, but this is local to your program. But assume that in your project, in many objects, we have the same field. For that field, I have to provide the same set of what? F4 values. So instead of associating the F4 help, instead of handling that event every time in each object, I can create a global search help. Why I'm calling this global? Because this is available at database level. If it is available at database level, it is reusable. I can attach it to what? Any number of what? Objects. So I'll go for what? Search help. So what is the meaning? Search help is used for what? Providing global F4 help. It is used for providing global F4 help. Once a search help is created, this search help can be attached at what? 3 different levels. We can attach the search help at data element level. We can attach the search help at selection screen input field level, or I can attach it in module pool screen level. At this stage, we don't know about module pool. When we discuss module pool, we'll see that. So as of now, let me create what search help. Okay. Again, we have 2 types of search helps: elementary search help and what? Collective search help. Collective search help I'll discuss tomorrow. As of now, let me focus only on what? Elementary search help. The difference between elementary search help and collective search help is, elementary search help will provide only one input path for F4 values, whereas collective search help will provide multiple input paths for what? F4 values. So let us focus on what? Elementary search help. So I'll give it as Z645. What? Elementary search help 1. I'm giving some name Z645 ESP1 create. Elementary search help. Continue. Done. Short description. I'll give the short description here. Done. Elementary search help. Done, done, done. Yeah. In the definition tab, you can observe we have a, there are many things here. All these things are not so much required. Focus on this one. What is this here? In the definition tab, we have selection method. This selection method indicates from where you want to get the F4 values. Selection method indicates from where you want to get the F4 values. So this selection method can be a database table. This selection method can be a database view, or this selection method can be what? Help view. When do we go for a database table? If you want to get the entries from only one table, you'll go for what? Database table. When do we go for a database view? If you want to get the entries from multiple tables, you'll go for what? Either database view or what? Help view. The difference is what? Database view will follow inner join, and LP view will follow what? Left outer join. Okay. So as of now, I can give what? A table name. Suppose if I give the table name as Z9A what? EMP, for example. Okay. So I'll get the F4 values from this particular table. Done. Then here I need to give the search help parameter. If I browse this, it will show all the what? Columns. So I'll go for what? Employee number. Okay, import, export, positions I have to give. Done. Okay, just save it. So what is the selection? Let me check it, activate. So what is the selection method I gave here? I gave the selection method as Z9AMEMP. So I'll get the F4 values from where? From where? From only single table. So if I can I execute this, yes. Okay, I'm executing as of now, but this search help, I can attach at data element level. I can attach at selection screen level, or I can attach at transaction level, that is at the module pool level. That we'll discuss going forward. I'll click on execute button. Yeah, employee. Okay. See here, when I browse this, yeah, it is showing what? Yeah, you can see how many entries here, 14 entries, because I gave employee table. Nah? In employee table, how many entries are there? 14 entries are there. We are having what? 14 entries, done. We are having about 14 entries. Done. Working fine. Working fine. So I can choose what? Any one of them. So I'll choose 9. I got it. Okay. Suppose if I deselect export here, I'm selecting only import. So when I execute this, search help, it's a warning. It's only a warning. Search help has no export parameter. Parameter EMP number is no longer the first export parameter. Done. Let me save it. Activate this. Activated using warnings. Done, no problem. Let me execute now. Yeah, okay, I'll press F4. I'm not getting anything here. Okay, here when I execute this, I'm getting this field, but I'm not getting the list of what? Values. Okay, suppose I'll select this export, I'll not select import. Let me save it, check it, activate this. Done. When I execute this, yeah, I'll browse this, I'll choose 7 here. Okay, I got 7. Continue. Yeah, sorry. When I attach it in the selection schedule, you understand the difference. So as of now, let me select both of them. So what I attached here, I attached the selection method is what? Database table. I'm getting the entries only from what? One table. Now let me select. What shall I select? Yeah, let me select the database view. What is the database view? Just now I created ZDB view EMP and what? Department. Yeah, ZDB view EMP department. Okay, so this database view will always follow what? Inner join. Na? So in the earlier inner join, how many entries I got? 7 entries only. So let me activate this. Done. Now when I execute, yeah, if you browse this, good. You can see how many entries it is showing only. 7 entries, because database view will follow what? Database will follow what? Inner join. So only these employees department numbers are available in what? Department table. Done. Now let me choose here ZHP view PMP department. Okay, help view will follow what? Left order join. Left order join means what? It will consider what? All the records of the left hand set table. So when I execute this, when I browse this, yeah, how many entries I got? 14 entries. Why I got 14 entries? Because I'm using what? Helper view. So if you go back to my helper view, yeah, this is database view. If I go back to the helper view, yeah, in this helper view, sorry, this helper view, yeah, in the helper view, you can see what is the left hand side table here. Okay, these are the tables, employee and department. Okay, so here the left hand side table is what? Employee is a left hand set table. So it is considering what? All the entries of what? Left hand set table. Okay, and this is the right hand set table. How many records are there in the employee table? 14 records are there. Okay, 14 records are there in the employee table. So even though these employees doesn't have the corresponding report number, it will still consider what? These rows. Right hand side will filled with what? Zeros and what? Null. So what I'm trying to show now is, when we are going for search help, in the search help, okay, in the elementary search help, the most important thing is that selection method. This selection method can be what? A database table or a database view or what? Help view. When do we go for database table? If you want to get the F4 values from only one table, you'll go for what? Database view. Sorry, a database table. If you want to get the entries from multiple tables, you'll go for database view or what? Help view. Database view will follow what? Inner join. And help view will follow what? Left outer join. So if you press F1 here, yeah, what is saying here? The possible entries for a tilde is okay, done. The selection method describes a database object from which the data is read. A database table or a view can be defined as what? Selection method. View means not all the views, only database view and what? Help view. Only database view and what? Help view. Understood? So what I'll do is, more about this search help I'll discuss tomorrow. Today we just understood the selection method here. Tomorrow we'll see what is the difference between elementary search help and collective search help, how to attach this search help at three different levels. Data element level, what selection screen input field level, or a transaction input field level. And we'll see the difference between elementary and collective, right? So any questions related to the selection method, please ask me. So we are done with the views concept. We understood all the four types of views. Okay, database view, projection view, maintenance view, and what? Help view. If you see here, I don't know whether it is there or not. Yeah, I gave the difference between these three views: database view, projection, maintenance view. Help view, just now we have seen. When do we go for help view? Help view, we can view it as what? Selection method in what? Search help. And help view will always follow what? Left outer join. Help will always follow what? Left outer join. So I gave the differences here. Just go through this. Same thing, whatever I discussed from last 2 days, the same thing I drafted here. You can just go through that. So tomorrow we'll see search help, two types of search help, and how to attach them at three different levels. And then we need to discuss about currency and what? Quantity fields and buffering. Right, okay. Right, so any questions for today, please ask me. Once again, let me just open the documentation. Help view in what? SAP ABAP. Yeah, you can see here. Help view is a special view for use in what? Search help. The selection methods of a search help can be good. You can see the selection methods of a search help can be database tables, database views, and the special help views. Yeah. Database table, yeah, that's what I told now. Database table restrict the search help to only one table, and database you restrict it to inner joints, whereas LPUs also makes what? Left outer joints possible. That's all. So this is a standard documentation. You can just go through this. Done. Any questions? So in dictionary objects, we are left over with search help, currency and quantity fields, and buffering concept, and types of what? Database tables. Types of database tables. Yes. Okay. So rest of the part we'll discuss tomorrow. Any questions for today, please ask me. Done. Chalo then, so we'll wind up, we'll continue tomorrow.